Seizure and epilepsy are used interchangeably. But to be specific, if you have one-time seizure or a single seizure, it's called seizure. But when it becomes habitual and repetitive, then it's called epilepsy. Seizures happen when a group of neurons or brain cells start sending repetitive or excessive electrical discharges, which they normally do, but not as intense as they do during seizures. And this electrical discharge may spread to the other parts of the brain. And then depending on where this electrical activity is located, it will translate into different clinical presentations. For example, if the seizure focus is in the left hemisphere that controls the right side, in the area that controls the right hand, then the patient may have his or her right arm stiffen up or shake. Or if the seizure focus is in the language cortex, then the patient will have speech arrest. Fortunately, epilepsy is treatable, and there are several medications for that. Up to early 90s, we didn't have too many medications, but fortunately now we have about 12 medications that are used to treat epilepsy. Of course, medications will have some degree of side effects, but we do our best by adjusting the medical therapy to avoid side effects while we avoid seizures. There is surgical treatment for epilepsy too. And by surgical treatment, mostly we are referring to finding or localizing the seizure focus and surgically removing that seizure focus. In other words, the bad tissue or neurons that are gone bad can be removed. That's called resective surgery. And there are other types of surgeries, in particular the one that's one of the standard treatments. It's called a vagus nerve stimulator. When a generator is placed under the chest muscle and the probe or the wire goes around the vagus nerve and sends impulses to the brain. In that case, we don't remove any part of the brain, but of course the efficacy would be less than a resective surgery. Here at Georgetown, we have an active epilepsy clinic, and we usually treat patients who have refractory epilepsy, and they are usually referred to us by our colleagues after they fail to respond to medical therapy. In such cases, we have to monitor patients in our epilepsy monitoring unit in order to record some of the seizures and find out if the seizures are coming from one focus or they are multifocal, or if they are coming from one hemisphere or from both hemispheres. That also helps to categorize the seizures, because some seizures come from one focus and spread to the rest of the brain. But there are seizures who come from beginning, from deep down in the brain, and simultaneously spread both hemispheres. There are different treatments for these different types of seizures. So after classifying and categorizing the seizures, then we'll have a plan for the treatment. If the patient happens to be a surgical candidate, in that case, our next step would be to find out exactly the seizure focus, if necessary, map the brain, and do the surgery. But in the meantime, of course, we always optimize the medical therapy, because medical treatment remains a mainstay of treatment for epilepsy, and even after surgery for a while, we continue medications. Fortunately, since early 90s, because of extensive research in epilepsy, there have been several new medications which turned out to be much better in terms of side effects and tolerability by the patients. And nowadays we use these medications as first-line treatment in epilepsy with better side effect profile.